Hi, welcome to another SkyMind screencast tutorial. In this example, we're going to demonstrate model saving and loading. This is the third part of a multi-part series. The first part, we loaded the data and used the DataVec tools to transform that data into a format suitable for use by our neural network. In the second part, we built a neural network and trained it against that data set. In this part, the third part, we're going to save that trained model and then load the trained model. Some of the tools we'll demonstrate is model serializer write model and model serializer restore multilayer network. If you're just getting started with Deeplearning4j, understand that there are more examples available to you at the repo in the first link, and then there's a quick start guide to help you get started using the examples. Thank you. In this example, I'm going to demonstrate how to save a trained neural net and how to load that pre-trained neural net. So I started with the MNIST image pipeline example, which demonstrated how to load a directory of images and to prepare them for processing in the neural net. In the second example of the series, I showed you how to add a neural network and test to validate if that neural net was reasonably useful. In this example, I'm going to show you how to save that trained neural net and how to load it. So I'm going to start by copying this example, the second one, the add neural net example. I'm going to give it a new name. I'm going to call it MNIST image pipeline example. Save. Just to review here, we have some settings that set some parameters. We use some DataVec tools to load the data, create a file split, create a record reader over that file split, then create a data iterator over that. And that presents us with data sets that we can pass through to our neural net. And then we build our neural network. And our neural network's called model. And then we train the model. After training the model, we evaluate the model. For this example, I'm not going to need the evaluate model part, so I'm going to comment that out. We've trained our model. Let's go ahead and save the model. So let's create a log line that tells us that we're saving the model. And what do we need to know? We'll need to know where to save. So I'm going to create a new file called location to save. And we'll call this trained MNIST model.zip. In addition to specifying where to save the model, we need to specify a Boolean on whether to save the updaters. If you wanted to do further training on this model, you would save the updaters. If you just wanted to use it to classify new data, you would not save the updaters. So in this case, I'm going to set the updater to false. So what model serializer needs is model name, whether or not to save updater, and then the location. So we have everything we need to go ahead and call model serializer. Let's go ahead and do that. There it is, model serializer. And we want to write the model. And then we need to specify we want to write our model, which we've called model. Specify the location to save. And then specify that we do not want to save the updater. So if we were going to go ahead and run this, it will train the model, read in our data set, label the data set, pass the data set to the model. We will not evaluate the model. We've done that in a previous example. So we should be able to go ahead and run this code. When that code completes, we see that it notifies us that it saved the train model. Let's take a look. Let's see what it saved. If I go to the Finder and find the file trained mnistmodel.zip, when we open up the zip file containing the saved model, we will see the coefficients stored in a binary format, so I'm not going to take a look at that, but we'll see the configuration that is stored in a JSON format. So we see our first layer, we see our second layer, and then the weights are saved in that binary format. Now that we've saved our model, let's write the code to load the model that we've saved. So I'm going to start with the save example, copy that, paste it, and rename it to load. And then let's go in here and get rid of what is not needed. Instead of building our neural network here, we're going to build it after we've loaded the data. So I'm going to get rid of all this multi-layer configuration. I'm going to get rid of this listener. I'm going to get rid of model init. To build our multi-layer network, we're going to load the saved model. So I'm going to take the saved information from here and move it up here. And then let's adjust some comments. So instead of saving a train model, we're going to load the train model. We're going to need the location to save. Save updaters, false, I don't think that's going to apply. And we're not going to be writing the model. And we're certainly not going to train the model. So let's get rid of this code. So now I think we have most of the pieces that we need. Right? We have the path to the saved model. And we're going to create our multi-layer network. Now, instead of calling multi-layer network to take a look at our configuration, we're going to have our multi-layer network created by asking model serializer to restore the multi-layer network from this location to save. So that line will load our model from the location where we saved it. Down here, we want to uncomment this code that evaluates the model. We do want to initialize our record reader. We want a data set iterator. We want to scale our image. We want to use the preprocessor to apply the scaling. So let's get the imports correct for here. Okay, we should be good. Just to review here, we're going to read the file that we've saved. We're going to create a multi-layer network using model serializer to read that data. And then we're going to evaluate it by reading our test data that we specified initially. So we're going to run the same evaluation that we've done previously. And let's go ahead and run the code. There we see the output. So we read the model from disk and we evaluated it over our test data set. With these examples, you should have the tools needed to save a trained neural net, load a trained neural net, and then evaluate the reloaded neural net. Thank you.